Welcome back to Dankout 3. This is Alex, also known as Solanus Dracone, and we're picking back up at the Citadel after just having had our formal introduction to the Brotherhood of Steel. The Citadel is actually set up in the ruins of the Pentagon, which I think is a pretty nice touch. The building most designated to the nation's security is where the Brotherhood of Steel have set down their roots in this region, so I thought that's nice. So, what we have to do now is, as per our quest, let's double check this here, to ask Scribe Rothschild for access to the pre-war computers. So, seeing as we have lost Daddy now, we no longer have any options but to move on with what he was trying to do. So now, our goal is to find the Gek. And look at these bastards running all over the place here. Scribe Rothschild. Actually, I want to have a chat with him.
You have my condolences. Your father was a good man.
Nah, not really interested.
Hail.
Hail. Alright, so as we come in here, we can see them working on this big badass mofo right here, Liberty Prime. He is the Bombad. He's basically the super OP robot that they have as their little ace in the hole. So let's go talk to Rothschild over here.
May I start by saying that I am sorry for your loss. I was acquainted with your father many years ago. The world has lost one of its few remaining visionaries.
Well, thanks for your sympathy.
Think nothing of it. Now, Dr. Lee has explained your predicament. You need to locate some Vault-Tec equipment?
Yep, my father was looking for the Gek. Got any idea?
A Gek? Goodness no, certainly not. I must say that there are some who doubt such a device really exists, let alone works. If, however, you share your father's determination, I may be able to assist you in locating one.
So, know how to find one, man?
Possibly. I'm afraid I won't be able to assist you directly. The news Dr. Lee has brought will require me to be elsewhere. I can, however, give you access to an old pre-war computer from Vault-Tec. It may have the information you need.
You'll find the terminal in the archives in the A-Ring.
Thanks for the help.
You are welcome. If you require further assistance, I may be able to help.
Rock on. So, yeah, we gotta find the vault that has the Gek in it. There are several known vaults in the area, but we need to find the one that's got the Gek. Now, I'm just gonna pop in here because...
Quartermaster Durga here, stranger. I have to say, I'm not sure what you're doing in my armory. We run a tight ship, and unless Elder Lion says so, we don't trade with outsiders. Quartermaster out.
Well, guess we can't trade with her. I was gonna try to do some trade. Lions!
Hail to you, son of James.
Hail. I'd like permission to trade, bruh.
This is not normally something that we do. Trade with outsiders has proven to be problematic in the past. However, considering the circumstances, so be it. I'll send word to Durga that you have full access to trade.
Thank you, that's what I wanted.
Hail.
Hail. Alright. Oh, there's a conversation.
What is it, Owen? The robot isn't going to fix itself.
About that, are you still having that issue with the head laser? I think the term you used was invariably destructive.
We've been over this. A slight modification to one system and all the subroutines go haywire. Don't worry, I'm on it.
Rothschild, old friend, you're a brilliant technician. But this old man's patience is wearing thin. I want a full status report in 3 hours.
Oh, very well. Now please, a giant robot to fix, hmm?
Always fun to hear them going at it. I try to catch conversations when I can, so Durga, let's do some trade.
I received word from Elder Lyons. He says that you have permission to trade with us. Good for you.
Well, don't sound excited about it. Let's see what you got.
Sure, just be quick about it.
Bitch, I'm giving you custom. Okay, I obviously want all the ammo. At least for the weapons that I use. Yeah, microfusion cells now that I've got something to use them with. Stim packs, as always. And now that we've traded that out, let's see what we can give you back. Ammo. I don't use certain things, like electron charge packs, energy cells, ooh, but that's... No, you're not getting that much out of me. Huh, wait. No, I lost money on that. Dang it. Oh, well. Whatever. Let's see. Nope, let's exit.
Gotcha. We'll see you next... I should let you...
Whatever, bitch. Okay, let's see what kind of, Nah, she doesn't do very good repair. Ech. Well, let's get the Chinese stealth armor repaired and the ghoul mask at least. Although, actually, we probably want to visit Soma for that because she does a better job.
Sure.
Alright, so let's continue to try and get our money back from her. And let's see. Energy cells 1300 times 2, that's about 2600. So let's try to see about trading in roughly 900. Let's trade this much. Great, okay. Nice. Let's try maybe another. Try a few more. Another 50, perhaps? Yeah, we can probably get away with 50. Oh. Great. Okay. Glad to have all my money back from this bitch. And she sells combat armor, but it's pretty low quality. Not really worth getting unless you're into that sort of thing.
A pleasure doing business with you.
I'll bet.
Of course.
Bye. Okay, so let's go find this here computer. Now, the way that the Citadel is set up is that it's set up in rings. And I think A ring is inner ring, B ring is outer ring. I don't know, I don't care. But yeah, just look for the Vault Tech computer, which is in this room, maybe? Nope, not this room. Next room. No? Yes? No? Damn. Not over here. I guess we actually have to go outside to the next ring. Fair enough. Let's climb us some stairs. And there's the door. It can be a little tricky learning your way around the Citadel, but it's not that bad. Just follow your compass marker and you'll get where you need to go. Gotta be careful, they got Galaxy News Radio going on here. That could get me permabanned. And... I think we gotta... No, we keep going this way.
The Brotherhood is at your service.
Thanks, babe. Okay, Vault Tech Terminal. So, let's take a look at the vault listings. Now, there's all these vaults, yeah, but 87's the one that has it. Equipment issuances, do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do, and we already get the thing. So let's not even waste more time. We go find Rothschild. Rothschild! And back across the courtyard. Oh, we could have just stayed in there. Alright. That's Rothschild. We see him walking.
Need something, friend?
Where are you? Wait, what? Oh, there you are.
Did you have any success with that old terminal?
Vault 87 has a geck. Don't know.
Ah, well, that much I believe I can help with. Step over here for a moment. I'll show you where it is.
Okay, so he's gonna lead us back out to the block spot. But he takes too long. Hurry. Damn you, hurry. Come on. Why do you have to go? Alright, I know where Vault 87 is. I've got the dang thing. I'm not gonna sit there through his spiel. Vault 87 is over here. and needed to get to it by going through Little Lamplight. So we could go to Rockbreaker's Last Gas, or we could go to the Yaogwai Tunnels. I think I'll head to Rockbreaker's just so I can maybe pick up one or two things along the way. I have no idea what's going to be anywhere when I go. But, oh, whoa, it's the Enclave. They are starting off. Oof, right through her face, cool. Alright. Woo! And now they're firing at someone else. Oh, wow. Oh, it's a super mutant. Don't tell me that my aim is that bad. God, stop! Stop it already, Jesus. This shit's getting crazy. There we go. What are they? Wait, what? Oh, they're shooting their fire sticks at me, okay. And I guess I'm burning a little bit. Hey buddy. Hi. Oh. I can hit you from here. Yeah, so I'm on fire, so what? I'm not speaking. iPod fucking Oh, that's awesome. Alright, finger, flamer fuel. Heavy incinerator looks fun, but I don't do big guns, so I'm not all that worried about it. And again, as always, if they have fingers, then they are evil. That is our justification for what we're doing. Yeah, let's take all the meds. Why not? And, whew. Boy, howdy. Alright, so it being nightfall, then, you know what, I'm just gonna do the waiting. It's gonna be a nice, I guess, 8 hours. So, yep, just wait away the time. Now that we've actually encountered the Enclave, we're getting full-on attacked by them randomly, so that's always just so much fun. Okay, now, contrary to what our quest marker is saying, I know where we need to go. So we're just going to set Little Lamplight as our marker, but we are going to go by way of Everglow. Where is that super mutant? You know what, I don't even care. I do not care. The super mutants do not possibly have any kind of gear that I am interested in getting right now. But let's put our ghoul mask back on. No, we can't. Hold on, I'm sure we can do this. Yeah, there we go, trick it out. Hold on, wait, what was that? Eyebot helmet, screw you. Why did I pick you up? I don't need that. Bottle cap mine, I'm not even all that hard up for, you know, money. Let's get rid of the frag grenade. And to be honest with you, the hunting rifles, I'm going to start putting away some of my weapons. Actually, I'm going to make it a point to do that, because I don't need to be carrying around all these extra lever action rifles. I have more than enough alien epoxy to keep my weapons topped up nice and fine for the rest of the game. Let's go find Everglow Campground, just to say we did. Nearby. Shouldn't be far now. Here we go. Now, every time I've ever come here, I have always been attacked by a Deathclaw. Oh, raiders, though. Always good for a laugh. Oh, yeah, you guys. You guys, you cracked me up. Hello? Load in, there we go. That's always, I love doing that. Just, they have all their ideas in their heads. They want to come and rile me up. And what happens? They get their shit blown up. Good times. Alright. And, wow, oof. Good job, you guys took out a super mutant. Don't need it. I think I've always... Yeah, there's some decent stuff to be had in here. And we'll just force this lock. Yep, yep, yep. It's railway spikes that weigh nothing, but they are... The fuck? Oh, wow. Hey, how's it going? Nice to meet you. And... Hold on, hold on, there's enough for everyone. Yeah. How do you like that Freddy Krueger is shooting your face? And... Wow, just more raiders. It's like Christmas. Alright, let's see if we can do this all in, 3 headshots. Ooh. Okay, so we at least we managed to kill someone, so Grim Reaper sprint kicks in. Perfect. Anybody else? Didn't think so. Okay. Waste not, want not. Okay, good time. So as I was saying, there's usually some decent stuff in this little caravan camper here. Plenty of darts, all the sugar bombs you could ever want, and guns and bullets, which isn't going to be useful to me at all. More bombs of sugar. And, no, I don't even know why I have the book. My guns are at whatever, I'm just going to use it. Wow, we are just over our limit. What can we do to lower our thing? Let's drink some water. Yeah, I desperately need to shed some weight at some point soon. So let's just go ahead and continue on with the quest. Our goal is to get to Little Lamplight Caverns. Now, if you're going to... if you thought you'd get it into your head, well, we'll just go straight to Vault 87. No, you won't. Vault 87 is 100% surrounded by unsurvivable rads. You cannot deal with those rads, no matter what amount of Rad-X you put in. Seriously, guys? I'm trying to talk. Thank you. He just flipped so hard. Come on, load in. Come on. Vats, don't die on me here. Oh. There we go. I should probably look for a perk that gives me more criticals. Because, I'm not one-shotting these guys as much as I like. Alright. Now then, no amount of radioactive protection that you can possibly think of putting, whether it be a rad suit, rad X, what have you, you cannot survive the rads outside of Vault 87. You just can't. It's impossible. You're never going to do it. Maybe if you spammed up some heavy-duty rad away as you were doing it, but just don't, okay? It's not worth it. You will definitely die. So we got us a Mr. Gutsy here, and I think we're seeing something happening on our right. Because I just saw a truck suddenly try to flip. Yeah, that bus just insta-flipped for absolutely no reason. What the hell, physics? Energy cell. Yeah, these are all good things. Wait, over here. Yeah. This away. And re-ammo. Jump through. Why not? Just have some fun. Okay, yeah. Sorry. We are facing the wrong direction. Wait, what? No. Okay, no. There we go. This way. I know it's down in a little bit of a gully. So, we don't have to go very far. Yep, I believe I see it over there. Okay. I got all turned about. That's what happens when you're not paying attention. Keep going. And here we see the entrance to Little Lamplight. Basically an underground sort of, you know, mining sort of a thing for kids. You took them inside to see the wonders of the under and all that, and that turned out to be a pretty damn good place for them to take refuge when the bombs started dropping. So basically a child society formed there somehow. And you know what? That's pretty cool, actually. So let's go ahead and head on in. And I just wonder what they're going to make of this visage right here. What they're going to make of this person coming in. Hi, kids! Okay, let's find out. So we already know we did a favor for Little Lamplight by saving those kids up at Paradise Falls way back when. So they should be fine.
Hold it right there, mister! Don't take another step or we'll blow your fucking head off.
The language on you. Hold on there, I'm a friend.
You're big, and I don't have any big friends. You better just go out the way you came in.
Can I come in?
Hell no! No mungos allowed!
And, of course, with child at heart, you know what? Your face looks like my butt.
Oh, yeah? You must like having such a good-looking butt.
Yeah, your mom sure likes it.
You're pretty funny for a mungo. Why don't you come on in?
And that should pretty much tell you everything you need to know right there about this society.
Happy birthday, Sticky.
The mouth on this kid.
Yeah, me too.
Ooh, conversation.
Sorry.
There's nothing happy about it. This is the worst day of my life.
It's time to go. You know the rules.
The rules are stupid.
You're a mungo now. You gotta leave.
Maybe I can stay just a little longer?
Bye, Sticky.
Yeah, bye, Sticky. Don't just stand there. Get
out
of here already.
Made any good jokes today?
Watch it. Not if I could help it. Made any good trades today?
Nah, Zip kept asking if I had any nuka cola hidden anywhere, so I told him I kept a six-pack hidden near a magic rock. He'll be busy for weeks, see?
Oh, man.
Hi.
And just yesterday,
how are you today?
I got him to believe one
do
of the rocks
dream about monsters?
Wishes.
I do.
I guess we make a good team,
about
even
time.
When we didn't mean to.
Hey, great stuff. Talk with you later, sis.
Okay, bye.
Because having them
hello.
Stars, they start trying Hi. To make rules all the time.
Watch.
And no one's like that. It's tradition.
You?
Wow! What luck! I'm Sticky. Forget these little kids. I'll take you to Big Town where the mungos. I mean, where the grown-ups. I'm headed there now. Nah, I'm a grown-up now. I can handle myself. There's no reason to waste your time with the kiddies at Little Lamplight. They'll steal your caps when you aren't looking. So let's go to Big Town. I can show you the way. I'm not allowed in Little Lamplight anymore. Only people under 18 get to live in Little Lamplight. So when you're done with those little kids, we can go to Big Town together. I'll wait outside for you.
Understand?
Get out of my face!
Hey, look, I don't just let any son of a bitch in my town. I'm taking a risk making an exception for you. So you're welcome in my town. At least until you start screwing up. Once that bullshit starts, you're out on your own again.
Not planning on any trouble.
Good. Better stay that way, Mungo.
I need to get to Vault 87.
It's not safe, even for someone as brave as you. There's monsters back there.
Monsters, huh?
The big ones. You know, the ones that sort of look like people, except they're all wrong.
So you know the way there?
Yeah, I do. It's through Murder Pass. Not a real safe way to go, but it's the only door that works.
That's the only way.
It's the only way that works, yeah. The other door hasn't worked since before I was here. Computer's busted, and not even Joseph can make it work.
Thanks.
If you're going to go through Murder Pass, let me know, and I'll have the door open for you. but I still say it's a bad idea.
I want to use Murder Pass.
You sure about that? It's scary in there. Even I don't like going in there, and I'm really brave.
Oh yeah, I'm sure.
Okay, if you say so. Come on, let's get the gate open for you, Mungo.
Yeah, you go do that. I have the sneaking suspicion that I had my mute button on while I was talking about Sticky. So, come on, Styx.
You want to go to Big Town? Of course you do!
Yeah, what's with the party hat, bruh?
Oh, I forgot I had that on. It was for my birthday. Here, you take it. I don't want it anymore.
Oh, gee, thanks. Big Town, I've been there before.
You have? I mean, of course you have. It's an awesome place. Well, enough talking. Let's get a move on. You are taking me to Big Town, right?
Yeah, let's go.
All right. Yeah! Big Town, here we come.
This poor guy, he grew up his entire life amongst the children. He grew up from being a child. Fuck your party hat guy. And now he's being kicked out of the only home he's ever known. So, you know what? Let's do him a solid. The folks at Big Town seemed pretty childlike themselves. So, let's ignore Sticky, and this is a real, real easy quest to complete if you've been to Big Town once, so I don't mind doing it real quick. You'll just go over on your world map and go to Big Town, and if you fast travel, your companions come with you.
There it is! We're almost there! Come on! Yippee!
Yeah. We're almost there. And now he's here. So, hey kid, come on. Where you going? Okay.
Hey, look at me. I'm in Big Town.
You sure are. Okay, so we have other work to get doing. Go to Little Lamplight, and we might as well remove the marker. So, yeah, Little Lamplight's a fun little town, and I always like to take a moment just to enjoy the ambiance, because they got these little, you know, Christmas lights. Some folks call them fairy lights. They're very nice. I imagine they've lost all their coloring over the years. Which, that's what happens with ceramic light bulbs, really. Fuck your party hat. Okay, so the dogs are pretty funnily named. You got Rex, and there's other dogs in here. Whoa.
Watch it.
What?
Thanks for getting Penny and Squirrel back. And Sammy too, I guess.
Alright, yeah, Sammy too, I guess. Cool. Okay, so we're supposed to be going to Murder Pass, which actually that's back the way they came, but I just want to take a quick look around. Oh, it's Bumble!
Whoa! You're big! You must be the biggest kid here! I'm the littlest kid. My real name's Betty, but mostly I get called Bumble. What do you call big kid?
Wow, what do I say? Sometimes people call me the Vault Dweller. It's nice to meet you. Yeah, I'll sound heroic. Why not?
It's nice to meet you, too. Did you come from the vault? I heard there's monsters down there.
Eclair told me once, one of them, they got him and bit him right in the face, and that's why he's only got one eye.
But you don't look like a monster, and I don't think you'd bite anyone in the face. You look like a nice Vault Dweller.
Yeah, cool. Why do they call you Bumble?
It's just a name, okay? Not my fault I knocked stuff over. Lucy says I still got a lot of growing to do.
Aw, sweet little thing.
Bye-bye, Vault Dweller.
Bye-bye. Aw. And it's just sad that she is actually the target of a quest that requires you to find a child and make a slave of them. It's pretty bad. Now, you don't suffer any karma loss just for looking, so just gonna look through the kids' stuff. I don't want any other ammo. Hey, Lucy.
You're new, and you're too big to be a resident. Who are you?
I rescued those captured kids. I'm a big hero. I'll use child at heart.
You brought back Penny and Sammy and Squirrel? Well, I guess that does make you a pretty big hero. Thanks. I'm Lucy, and I'm pretty much the mom around here. And that means I spend a lot of time kissing boo-boos and making things all better. So if you ever get any scrapes or bruises, or if you get shot, stabbed, or radiated, stop by, and I'll do what I can, big hero.
Aw, sweet. What do you got for sale? She only gives medical treatment. All right.
Thanks. Hopefully, it'll just be skin, knees, and bloody noses today.
That's right. So, yeah, she's the doctor. It's amazing that they actually managed to put together a pretty decent functioning society here.
Watch it.
Look, honey, I got better things to do than running around when you run into my face telling me watch it. Oh, where are you going, kid? Don't be afraid.
Hey.
Hey. What's up? Who's that? Oh, he's just a random kid. Okay, and there's Hooligan. Hey, Hooligan, who's your good boy? Okay. To the left, you've got their great chamber. I have to turn the light off. And that's just their little living quarters there, and I'm not all that interested right now. And through here, this is sort of their great cavern, I guess. And murder passes over that way. Here you got the bathrooms, obviously. And yeah, so there's a shop in town.
Hey.
It's up at the top of... Move it, kid. It's up at the top here. And I'm wondering if your boy is going to be up here. Hey, Knick-Knack.
You in town, huh? If MacReady let you in, that's good enough for me. Well, enough with formalities. Who are you? And how'd you get MacReady to let you in here?
I'm the big hero, yeah.
It sure isn't bad. Nice work bringing them back. You didn't happen to bring anything else back, did you? Gear, equipment, bric-a-brac? Speaking of which, I'm Knick-Knack, and I run the store down here. If you want to trade anything, come on by the souvenir store and we'll talk.
Cool. Let's trade.
Sure thing, pal. Special deals for us kids.
Yeah. And he's actually got some decent stuff here. It's not a lot, but, you know, it's good prices. Heck, a single cap? Oh wait, I didn't want your shitty 5mm ammo. Take it back. Not bad, not bad. He's got some decent stuff. 9 stim packs, yes. Excellent.
Come again. I should have... Come on back when you got more stuff to trade.
Cool. Alright, so, yeah. That's more or less little Lamplight. I'll just take one more little peek into the other cavern just to kind of explore the whole place. There's not really a lot of great interest here, but it's, you know, I just like to think, oh, these kids are doing just fine. The kids are doing good. They got their whole society set up. Food, yay. Look at this. Mmm. I ain't drinking that water. Mm-mm. No, no. And they listen to Enclave Radio, apparently.
Hey, what's up?
Fun times and laughs as always.
Okay, bye.
Okay, bye.
Fun times and laughs,
great.
Goodbye.
RJ let in another pair of choppers to eat up all our food. Well, as long as you don't give me any crap about how I prepare your grub, I guess you'll be okay. So tell me, what do you think of K-fungus and watery mushroom sauce?
I'd rather eat a Brahmin turd sandwich with no bread.
You got that right. After our regular meals, I bet some of us would give that a shot. If we had a Brahmin down here, that is. Listen, my name's Eclair. Don't laugh. And I'm in charge of the food down here. We haven't got much. But I do what I can to spice it up. If you need a meal down here, just talk with me. You'll hardly even know you're eating cave mold.
So I think... Yeah, let's childhood heart him.
Bon appetit!
Aw, he knows that word. So, alright, usually they've got stim packs, not today. Boop, 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 where do you get food?
Honestly, when we can't scavenge some from outside, we mostly scrape it off the walls and skim it off the water. No, really. Most of our food comes from fungus that grows in these caves. It's not so bad when you get used to it, and we don't have much choice. At least it's filling, so we don't have to eat much of it. But man, oh man, it tastes terrible!
Where does the fungus come from?
It's pretty hard to find, and I hear it doesn't grow in other caves. I don't know why it's here, but without it, we'd be goners. Think fungus just grows on trees? No, it grows in caves! Ugh, Knock Knock came up with that one once, and now it's stuck in my head forever! Doesn't take any work to get it to grow down here. All I have to do is collect and prepare it. Mostly, I try to get the stink off it.
How does it grow?
They say the fungus grows in the pools where the first lamplighters sent the Mungos. That's about the most they ever helped us. I don't know how true that is, but I know sometimes the scav team comes back with this strange meat that tastes terrible, but the fungus loves it. I don't know where they find that meat, but if you could bring some back, I'd be glad to trade fungus for it. Of course, McCready'd have to okay it.
That's all I need to know.
Sure. About time, man. This mold isn't getting any tastier.
So, okay, sort of the hint that the fungus grows off of human flesh. Wow. I thought I remember being able to trade buff out to these kids. I don't know where I'm remembering that from, but, you know, I don't want to give drugs to kids. Who knows what they get up to down here. Just top up my gun. And I might as well shed a little bit of weight, so I'll repair it. There we go. Just try to get rid of some weight, that's all. Yep. I honestly have no need to be holding on to these things anymore. Alright, that at least freed up some weight. Hi, Rex. They have others. My favorite's Muttface. They just call the dog Muttface. That's just clever childness. Okay, so back here is the way to Murder Pass. Let's talk to Princess.
Hey, new kid. I don't know if anyone told you yet, but let me set the record straight. I'm Princess. When you're around me, I'm in charge. You shut up and do what I say, because I'm boss around here. That clear? Now, who are you?
Did you just try to give me orders? That's cute, little princess.
Oh, you'll listen to me. Otherwise, I'll have my good pal RJ kick you out of the town. Or better yet, lock you in the vault. So don't push me, new meat. Just nod and move on, and I think we'll get along just fine.
Wow. How did you get a name like Princess?
I don't need to explain myself to you, Mungo. Shut up and get lost. In fact, don't you ever bother me about something as stupid as nicknames again.
Nice. What's it like guarding the back gate?
It's so dull. Practically nothing ever tries to come through the back gate anymore, so I never get to shoot anyone. I wish I was at the front gate, but RJ specifically put me back here. Up front, at least there's a chance I can shoot some unwanted visitors. Which could have included you, Mungo.
Why would you have shot at me?
Could have been a lot of reasons. Maybe you sounded like a monster in all that darkness. Maybe you had a weapon drawn and looked like a raider. Maybe I just decided I didn't like your stupid Mungo face.
Wow. Cute kid. Let's just ask her one more. I like her mouthing off to me.
No, scram.
All right. Bye.
Later.
Yeah. So we kind of missed the whole gate opening thing. I think if we talk to Sammy, we can get some dirt on Princess and make her cry, but I have no desire to do that. So, yeah, that's Little Lamplight, and this leads into the tunnels which lead to Vault 87. But that's going to be for another episode. Thank you for watching. I am Solanus Dracone, also known as Alex, and this has been Dankout 3. Thank you very much, and good night.